Student movement March for Our Lives. In Portland, about 12,000 people took part. This is Air 12 video from Saturday in Portland. People of all ages took to the streets to call for an end to gun violence in schools. And even though the march is finished, the students' mission is far from over. Part of that is trying to get a measure on Oregon's November ballot that would ban assault-style weapons. A group in favor of ballot measure 43 delivered more than 3,400 signatures to the Secretary of State's office in Salem this morning. Fox 12's Marilyn Deutsch has more on why pro-gun advocates say this isn't the answer to fighting gun violence.
The group needed just 1,000 sponsorship signatures. It got more than three times that many. Many from folks at Saturday's student-led March for Our Lives rally. In Northeast Portland this morning, sponsors, supporters, and students boarded a bus at the Augustana Lutheran Church with petitions in hand to drive the signatures to Salem. An interfaith group is sponsoring the measure that would ban the sale of assault weapons and large capacity magazines. The group says it's been inspired by the student-led protests here in Oregon and across the country since the Parkland school shooting. The Secretary of State's office has to verify the signatures, then the measure goes to the AG's office for comments. There can also be legal challenges to the measure. Among those on the bus today, a former high school principal and a high school student who spent the first day of his spring break on a political mission and recalling a recent mass shooting scare at his school.
Someone posted something on Snapchat and it circulated around the school, and it was like someone had drawn on the desk, like, I'm gonna shoot up the school at like 12:27 or something. It's definitely something that a lot of people are really scared about.
I am excited about students getting this involved, because I've always believed if you give students the opportunity, they will get the work done.
Best case scenario, say supporters, is that they could begin statewide signature gathering in a month. And they can expect some fierce opposition from gun owners who don't believe an assault weapons ban will keep students or other Oregonians safer.
The momentum behind the march is admirable, and we respect that, but it needs to be directed at what's going to actively affect some change. And going into 100 million American homes and telling us, give us all of your guns that are sitting there in the gun safe, not doing anything to anybody, that's not going to solve any problems. Criminals, by definition, don't follow laws. They're still going to get their hands on guns. They're still going to commit heinous crimes.
Meantime, backers of Measure 43 say they are training 2,000 people to gather the 88,000 signatures necessary to get this measure on the ballot in November. In Salem, Marilyn Deutsch, Fox 12.